We are on the set of Mr. D in Halifax, Nova Scotia. We have a lot of fun. It's a fun group to work with. You know, comedy is really difficult. You know, you're only as funny as the people you work with, and I'm very lucky to have a lot of funny people around me that, you know, help run the ship.
One of the things that I find really funny is people whose confidence is writing checks that their ability can't cash. That's just one of the oldest comedic tropes of all time.
Get me off.
What?
Try and get me off, Mr. Duncan.
This is my favorite Mr. D quote. Never give up. Because never give up is true, but then Jerry goes, ever. And you go, that's what you do.
Yeah, I mean, it's a group effort. Certainly not just me. And yeah, I think we created some really funny stories.
Are you thinking straight? Pass him. We don't have to see him again, right? We shouldn't be failing kids we don't like. That should be a rule.
That is rich.
The bench is so deep on this show. Everybody knows their way around a joke. Everybody can crack everybody else up. And it seems to be a nice blend of wanting to strut and show off a little bit for the other cast members, try to make them laugh, and also pick your moments to sit back and watch and be amazed and genuinely enjoy what the other people in the show are able to do.
We're always trying to make the show funnier right to the last second. I think that's what's unique about the show.
Oh my gosh! Go eat that in the conference room, please. That's a smelly food eating area now.
Jerry.
I'm surprised and delighted on a daily basis at any number of people in the cast.
You know, I still have trouble talking. I can hardly breathe sometimes. But that doesn't interest you, does it? No.
See what comes and goes?
And then it just goes. How am I supposed to teach?